they can reconnect. Hallelujah. And you know what the Bible says in Isaiah 60, just verse 1, that one arise, it has so many meanings. To arise, hallelujah. It is somebody who has not been active. It is somebody who has not been surfacing. And to arise is to get up. I'm here to tell you, woman, get up. Hallelujah. Throw that blanket away. It is your time to arise. Hallelujah. It is to start to exist. I'm defining that word, arise. Arise. Start existing. Don't behave like you are dead, yet you never called us for your value. Hallelujah. Father, I give you praise. It is to resume existing. Hallelujah. It is to reappear. Hallelujah. For those who have been in hiding. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For those who have been in hiding. You know what it took you in hiding. Could be offenses. Unforgiveness. Women. Hey, heartache. People hurting you. Hallelujah. And you felt now, I cannot. And especially offenses. Women, you are known. The Spirit of God is telling you to arise. It is to service. To come out of the hiding. It is to emerge. Emerge. It is to occur. It is to pop up like popcorns. Pop up. It is to pop up. It is your season. I know I'm speaking to a woman there in the office, even if you are in your home, like Jaheri. Hallelujah. Even if you are prophetess, like who? Deborah. I'm here to tell you, arise, because it is your time. It is, I've said, to appear. Hallelujah. That is what the Spirit of God is telling women. If you forget anything else, don't forget about arising. Isaiah 60, verse 1. Arise and shine. So there is a purpose for you to arise. You are going to arise and do what? Shine. Wherever God will lead you. Shine in the marketplace. Shine in your ministry. Sign in your house. Sign in your business. Sign wherever you are. Hallelujah. Wakati wako wakukaa kama kuku imenyesha wa umeisha. Tumekuja kukuamusha. Na sio kukuamusha tu. Tutakuvuruta. Togo kogusia. Utoke mahali huko. Because you are right has come. Hallelujah. And the glory of the Lord has risen up to you. Hallelujah. Now I just want us to see today we are going to read many scripture. Get set. I love scripture. Scripture. It is from the scripture we are going to see the praise of women as far as God is concerned. Why? Because women, you are not what people says you are. You are not what culture says you are. You are not what society says you are. You are not what your relatives says you are. You are what God says you are. And to know that, we must go to the word of God. As the Bible says in Psalm 139 verse 14, you are fearfully and wonderfully made. Meaning you are unique. It is the time we are calling the uniqueness that is in women. Because it is needed. And it is their time to be active. It is their time to be aggressive. It is their time to serve God with all what they have. Rabakanta rababozaya. With all what you have, including your shape. Hivyo anakuambia you are suppressed. Roba sheka taramayanda. The way, Father, I give you praise. Hallelujah. Just the way you are You must refuse what people says concerning you, because that is the trap of the enemy to bring women down. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how you dress. As long as you are clothed, you are dressed, you are not naked, you are good to go. Hallelujah. Yo ingina itakupatanga mbele ukiendanga. Hallelujah. Amen. Father, I give you praise. Hallelujah. So, what is it that God says about women? I just want us to read Genesis chapter 2, verse 18. Father, I give you praise. God and women in mind. Women, we are not afterthoughts of God. Hallelujah. God ya kuchukua munda kufikilia kama aumbe wanawake. Hallelujah. And I just want us to lean so that we can. We start from there. When you know who God says you are, or who you are in God, I'm telling you, you will not allow anything to stand before you. You will not allow anything to hinder you to become the very human God wants you to be. And I'm speaking to women. I'm speaking to renders. Usiseme ate mi, I'm not a human because I'm a girl. Wewe ukiwa ni mwanamke maumbire. Amen. I'm speaking to girls. Amen. Yes. Father, I give you praise. I'm not speaking to married women. I'm not speaking to widows. I'm not speaking to the rejected. I'm speaking to women at large. Ukiwa unajua God created you as a woman. Answer up. I'm speaking to you. And the Bible says, and the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him. The praise of a woman as far as God is concerned. And do you know when I was reading this verse, I saw if God could give out a woman just to help, who is stronger? Watcha. Who is stronger than the other? The one who is being helped or the one who is helping? Yes. Because you are first helped yourself. That is why you are able to to help somebody else. You cannot give help if you don't have. So I have double help. My help and your help. Say amen. Musinistone. Hallelujah. Amen. I can see people are like, but that is the truth. Yes. How can you call somebody to help you if she is not able? Yes. It is because I have double helping, double anointing, double grace. Everything a woman has, double love. Hallelujah. That is the praise of a woman as far as God is concerned. God himself saw the need of a woman. It's need. The Lord God said, it is not good for a man. He saw the need of a man. That's why he was able to give what? To give help. Genesis 2. Go up to verse 22. The same. Remember, it is the praise of a woman as far as God is concerned. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman and he brought her to the man. So women, they were not afterthoughts. They never came. They were in the mind of God. What is it that is making you? And I'm here to let women know. I'm telling you, you are the one who is stopping you. You yourself, you are the one who is hitting yourself. Yes, it is not God, it is not a witch doctor, it is you. Because you have refused to what? To appreciate your praise as far God is concerned. Hallelujah. Genesis 1, 27. God created both Ninataka unionyese. The Bible is saying God created. He took time to think about what he was creating. Women! And that's why I feel like sometimes I can slap some when they are calling themselves, I'm for nothing. I'm good for nothing. You are not good for nothing. You better even say like what one of our mathematicians teacher was telling us. Some of the people, the girls' ears are good for manure. Amen. Because of not passing mathematics. You, my teacher, my mathematics teacher, look at what I'm doing now. I was not good for manure. I was not good for manure. Nimekasirika. Hallelujah. So, God created man in his own image. Wow. Mtu akikuona na tia Elisa viasi, apande. Naona wewe ni manure. God forbid. Women arise, we are not good for manure. I was told that by my mathematician teacher. I don't want to mention your name, Mr. So, God created man in his own image. Amen. In the image of God, he created him, male and he created. We were both created. Hakuna wanyuma na wa mugongo, as they say. Hallelujah. That is your praise has been God. Listen. So God created man and in his own image, in the image of God. He created him male and female. Why are you behaving like you are not created? Some women behave like they were hatched. Hallelujah! Amen! Oh my goodness! Women, arise! I'm making you angry so that you can arise. Hallelujah! We are both created. And we are created in His image. You look like God. Ah, woman! If I tell you, you look funny. Tell them, no, I'm not funny. I look like God. Amen. Sometimes I may ask you, wewe unakaa kama nani? Naweza kosa kukaa mtu yoyote huku lakini kae kama God. That is a better praise. That is what the Bible says. Father, I give you praise. Hallelujah. Yes. Another scripture. Colossians 1. Yes. If you know who you are, as far as God is concerned, you don't need to tell somebody to help you to arise. Hallelujah. You just arise. Hallelujah. You don't need to call for prayers. Hallelujah. You just arise. Why? Because what I'm teaching is nothing but the truth. What does the Bible say concerning the truth? The truth will set us free. You are there. You want us to come with things here so that you can be set free. No wonder munandanganywa nyinyi juu mumekata. Ukienda mahali kuna kale sarakazi ni women tu. Mahali vifagio zinaitizwa kwa mama ndio wengi. Chumvi kuchanganywa na kitu ingine ndio itoke ni wewe. Juu umekata utajandanganywa. Na mimi hapa naongea ukweli unipendi lakini utandu. Hallelujah. Father, I give you praise. I'm helping you. I'm coming with the truth. The truth is the word of God. Siko na sarakasi hapa. Ningekuja hapa na sarakasi na matawi na nini. Nipitia hapa hivi. Tuko CBD by the way. Ungeona watu wakinifuata. Sai mnaniona. Nikienda nikate matawi, nijifunge, nivae goggles na kingunia hivo. Ninue mikono. Niseme kunjeni, kunjeni. Mutaona mkinifuata. Watu wanapenda uongo. Father, I give you praise. Colossians. Paul. I know so many people say it's Paul and no place for women. But I want you to challenge you with the word of God. Colossians 1, verse 8 to 10. Riba saka tarabayanda. Hallelujah. God is here together with us. Because we are speaking his word. We are sharing his word. And the Bible says in John 1:1, in the beginning there was word. The word was with God. And the word was God. God is together with Hallelujah. That's why we are strong and we are bold. People are like, "Oh, mama, where, my friend?" Sikuwa hivyo, but I thank God. This boldness, it is a weapon. By the way, it is my strength. Who also declared us your love is? Colossians 1, 8, 10. Let me see 10. Where the Bible says, we are complete in Christ. We also declare to us your love in the Spirit. Let's see. 9. Let's see. For this reason, we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to ask that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. These are blessings of God coming to everybody, not for men, that you may walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing Him, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God. There is a scripture I'm looking, I know I'm going to find it. Women have both the nature of God. They are able to access God. Hallelujah. You have the image of God, meaning you have His likeness. You are the reflection of God. You are God representatives. Hallelujah. God made women. Oh, Colossians 2:10. Thank you. Thank you, woman of God. That is the verse I'm looking for. What does it say? And good. And you are complete in Him. Who is the head of all principality and the power? What other power are you fearing? If God is telling you, woman, you are people may see you like you are half. Umesatembea watu wanakuona kama umebakia. Amen. Amen. Yeah, even in your family, when you come out, they are like, "Uyu naye, my friend, kuwa rafiki wa Yesu, you are complete in Him." Yes, the way I am, I may not have what you are looking for, but I am complete in Him. Hallelujah. Meaning I can do all things through Him because I know Him who strengthened me. That is the issue of relationship, knowing Him. Being in Him, growing in Him, hallelujah, maturing in Him. Father, I give you praise. The other one I want us to see, God made women equal to men, but with a different faction. God never made you less than men. We are sons of God, all of us. Hallelujah. Romans 8, 14. We are sons. This is what made us equal. Hallelujah. Isi kama ile upeleke CV. Hallelujah. This is not about sowing the muscles. It is about knowing the truth. Hallelujah. What does the Bible say in Romans 8:14? For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are. Who are many? Have you seen it for as many men? Are you seeing as many boys? It is as many people, plural, everybody. So find your place to become a son of God. And you are good to go. And indeed what? For as many as are led by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. If I become a woman who has been read by the Spirit of God, automatically I become a son. No other qualification, no test. Hallelujah. No examination. Nothing like a diploma degree in this qualification. Hallelujah. We are sons of God, and we need to fight for our inheritance as per God is concerned. Hallelujah. This is more than a plot or a quarter an acre of a land. When you discover who you are in God as a woman, you already have an eternal inheritance. And nobody can tunya you. Nobody can snatch it from you. Women, arise. Hallelujah. So those who ask, where are these women? They have boldness there. It is because we have discovered our possession. Not only possession, I have discovered my city number, who I am, as far as God is concerned. And I cannot allow anyone to sit on that seat. No matter what. My seat, I know it. I know even the color. Wah! I know who I am in Christ. Watch out, evil. Yes, I know. I'm a son. Hallelujah. Yes, I'm a son. We need to lead also John. Those who believe in him. John 1. 12. Discovering who you are. That is where we need to start. This is what God wants us to hear today. When you discover who are you in him, when you discover your place in God, my friend, finding your place of assignment, it will be very easy. Finding you are Deborah, you know, like those people we read in the Bible, those remarkable women. It is very easy. Praying like Anna, you know, overcoming the strife and the depression of Penina. It will be too easy. But in the problem you find yourself there, it is because you don't know who you are. Hallelujah. That's why this lady never argued with Penina. My friend, Guy, munafikiria hiyo ni mchezo. Penina, Penina ingekuwa ya mwili na wengine. Tuonane makofi. We fight for our husband. Amen. Fighting for our husband. But because that woman knew who she was, that's why she behaved the way she behaved. Mature women, they don't strive. They wait for God to fight for themselves. You think we are preaching because we don't have issue? Yeah! Hallelujah! You think I'm here because I'm not opposed? You think I'm standing here because could be I'm coming here and last night I cried? But to me, that one, I don't carry such things. They are too heavy for me. And I must take care of my heart. Hallelujah. Proverbs. Taking care of your heart. Linda, linda, moyo wako. Hallelujah. Kwa sababu ndani ya moyo wako kuna chemuka visima. Sina uhai. That's why we are able to speak life. When we preach life. Hallelujah. It is not because we don't go through issue. We go through issue and overcome. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We jump handles. Hallelujah. You don't know how many have jumped this week. Hallelujah. Father, I give you praise. Wengine wanafikiria tunatoka mbinguni. Unatoka mbinguni unje chini. Huku ndiyo kazi iko. Hallelujah. Are we there? John 1:12. Father, I give you praise. Those who believe in him, he gives them power to become children of God. Those who believe, those, all of them, find your place to believe in him and you receive power. I love this. Those who believe, but as many as received him, to them he gave the light to become children of God. To those who believe in his name. Hallelujah. Just believing. Are you seeing men called apart? So that they can just believe and become children of God. Hallelujah. 20. Galatians 3:28. I know this woman of God is delivering people. Because the truth is the word of God. And I know the enemy does not want people to read the word of God. I'm still looking for those women of God who be able, you know, to analyze the word of God, to stay in the word of God, to stand in the word of God. As the Bible says, stand yourself to sow.
already approved. Let the word of God examine you. That's why unaona ukiita mama wananga neno. Wanakunja na wimbo ya samani mwingine anakuja usunda mrefu. Come with the word. Yes, we must stand in the word of God. For he who worked effectively. Where are we? 3. Galatians chapter 3, verse 28. Hallelujah. Discovering your praise as far God is concerned. That is the starting point. After that, when God gives us time, we will continue now seeing what those women who discovered themselves, what they were doing, how they were doing ministry. Hallelujah. Yes, and most of them have discovered they loved Jesus so much. We are going to see one of them right now. I love. You are looking for Galatians 3. You may stop in dogo. Don't you worry. It is okay. Hallelujah. It's okay. Here we can light to Tasoma. It says, there is neither Jew nor Greek, slaves nor free, male nor female. For you are all one in Christ. That is what it says. For you are. Sasa mbona munajitoa toanga wa mama. I think we sometimes make Jesus feel so annoyed. Yes. He is telling us, you know, there is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither slave nor free. There is neither male nor female. For you are all one in Christ. Na unakuta mama akisema, mimi ni kama tu mzee atangulie. Huku tunawekangwa na mzee tu. Hallelujah. Mimi siye kwa mzee. Mimi nawekangwa na Yesu. Because I know we are all one in Christ. Hallelujah. Women arise. I just want us also to write some of the scripture because I'm looking at time. We can go and read like Genesis 1, we learned women received the same mandate. Women received the same mandate. Let's do this. Let me obey God. Yes. Genesis 1:28. Women received the same mandate as men. God blessed them. He said, be fruitful and have dominion. Mwanamke ukinuka kidogo hivyo, wanakupatia njina. Are we there? Then God blessed them. Who are those who are blessed? Then why are you just staying here like you are not blessed? Who bewitched you? It is you yourself, isn't it? No wonder ukienda kwa muganga anachanganyikiwa because it's your yeye. Jesus, God blessed them. Hallelujah. Wanawake mukinawili, wanaume musisikie wivu, musome hii maandiko. They were both blessed, like you are. So they can hone V8. They can hone the big buildings. Kwani, what's wrong with that? Na kusiwe na kasoro, wacha kemwaru, corporate. Anaweza, by the way, I'm addressing something here. Women, you can join with a man and you become blessed more than him. And that will not do what? Will not stop you to humble. Because it is a principle. Hallelujah. The word of God. The God, by the way, it is not something very unique. Kwanini, by the way, wanaonekana hata ate unawavulia. Wanawake nimekosa kumutambua. Mukibarikiwa ni wandi ya Mungu inanini. Amen. Yes. God is fulfilling. Then God blessed them. It is something God is saying. So when it comes to pass, it is not a big deal. Where? It is not a big deal, woman, to honor V8. Now to the end, humble. Watch a panganga. Amen. Yes, it is not something that is so strange. It's written here. Both were blessed. A man can be blessed. And equally, yes, both of you, you can write equal checks. Hallelujah. Yesu ni Bwana. Where you can take equal responsibility. Why not? Yes. If I'm blessed, I can pay the school fees. Kwani, what's wrong with that? You think kusema nikalie chapati. Nimekasilika. Ni neno la Mungu. Hallelujah. Na hiyo si kusema nimekuwa wangu wa makeli. Hata nikiendelea tu hivyo. Wanaume unajua wanashinda. Wacha niwaambie. They suffer inferiority complex. Wakati mwanamke tu anabarikiwa. Ukibarikiwa sutavaa nguo mzuri. Na kiatu mzuri. Uongeze stockings. Na viatu mrefu. Ukitembea tu hivyo inashuka. Kwa nini wewe? Angalia neno. Hallelujah. Yes. Na unaanza kuwasa usiku mzima ate vile anaendelea mimi naona unaanza vita ate umuharibie sura wewe hiyo ikome be fruitful and multiply atanunua mafuta mzuri ya kitanjirika ya kumufanya smooth na lipstick ile itokangi haraka na ni expensive fill the heart and subdue it have dominion over the fish have dominion both having dominion Sikusema te umekuwa mutawara. Hallelujah. Hiyo ni asiku ingine. I think, yes men you are end. We don't dispute that. We love that. You are the end. Kaeni hapo na musitoke. But you cannot move without this man. You can kaa hivyo. Nikikosa kumove neck. Hiyo ni. Neck ndia inakuambia left, right. Left, right, cross. We! Angalia left, usigongwa na ngali light. Tena cross. Because it is flexible. Father, I give you praise. Iyo, iyo, tutaongea. Eh, mukinita nitaongea. Couples meeting, yes. That's my position. Hata I don't even undermine, I'm becoming the end. But I want to remain in the neck. It is a bit flexible. I'm like, oh my goodness. Guy, Father, hallelujah. Taking dominion. Women received. God filled them with the Holy Spirit. Isasa ndiyo naona kama ni nzuri saindi. Joel 2, 28, 29. Amen. Ukikutana na mumama hapo. Akiwa juu yeye ni nani. Tafadhali umuambie pointi mbili. And do you know what that will do? We don't deliver her. Because the word of God, the truth, brings freedom. Isn't it? That is what the Bible says in John. When you hear the truth, it will set you free. That setting free is deliverance. So deliverance, you don't need somebody to come here and vomit. Amen. I don't need you to come here, woman. And some of you are too heavy. Munaona kamkono kangu, sina nguvu ya kuambia, hamuka, nyanyua, nyanyua, leta tena. Apana, me, I disperse the word. Mimi tafadhali. You and yes, Pastor Weber, nisaidie. Na woman of God, ile jina. Mimi sinanga nguvu yo. Kwanza unanistuanga. Mimi sitakangi masala kazi. Amen. Natakanga ulale kabisa. Na hiyo kulala kabisa nimegundua ni worship. Sin deliverance. We. Hallelujah. So, let's read. Joel 2:28-29. Father, I give you praise. Easy point. They are going to deliver you. Knowing you are praised in Christ. As far as God is concerned. And this is what the enemy is hindering us not to. Ananjaribu sana. Ndiyo unaona anapeleka wa mama. Mahali hakuna neno. Angalieni mahali hakuna neno. Wa mama. Ah, by the way. Someone told me. From the church that I minister. Because in the church that I minister. God has given me more women. More men than women. Amen. I know you are witness. And you know. When they were. One day they were doing their men Sunday. One man stand up and say, you see why we are many here? Because there are no lies. Ati apa tundanganyangwi. And yo tuko wengi. Kwa sababu men cannot stand to be in a congregation where there are lies. Point. Mahali mahali kuna kutanganyika, leta mbegu, leso, kebati, mama. Mosuba wa maguta, ma kerea totange kura maguta we kerele, wewe. Tena wewe ndio unabeba mafuta. Ndio unaona munashika vibeti, sisi nyanganywe na ukifikiria ni pesa, kumbe ni chupa ya mafuta unalinda hivo. Oi, bondage. May God have mercy. Amen. Kuna mahali moja nilikuwa naenda maombi. And when I was coming out of that prayer center, nikakutana na women I knew. Walikuwa wanangonja wafike mahali pamejificha, watoe tule tumafuta walikuwa mahali kuchukua. So nilikuta nikitoka kwa getu wana tumafuta wanaonyeshana. Akakangu siku njasiwa. Ona, ona. Waliponiona nikafungua kiona nika saa wa oh! Monja botro yanguke. Hallelujah. May God deliver women. May God deliver women. And why do they need to be delivered? Scripture, my people perish for the lack of knowledge. Becoming knowledgeable, it is from the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Knowledgeable from the word of God. God filled them with their joy. Let's read. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit to all. Ana sasa. Unajiondoa like you are not afresh. Who are you? Are you a beast? Unaona? Tunakosea maandiko. Kungekuwa kuna watu watapatiwa punishment. Ni wale watu wako ignorant. Because they are going to perish for the lack of knowledge. Soma maandiko mzuri. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. Uh-huh. Father, I give you praise. 29. And also on my men servants and on my maid. Imagine. Hallelujah. I will pour out my spirit on who? On my man servant and my maid servant. Kwa nini Mungu hakuacha hapo aweke full stop wakati amefika man servant? God filled them. Discovering your place in God. You can write also Acts 2:17-18. We can go very there first. Na tuko na time juu after this two tutaomba. Because next time if God give me time I'll go to another topic. But we need to discover who we are. Let's lead together. And it shall come to pass in the last days, says God, that I will pour out. Let's say. On all flesh. These are the last days. You cannot make it without the Spirit of God. That is the Holy Spirit. Yes. We are in the last day. Your sons and your daughters, the same one. Your young men and shall see visions. Your old men shall dream dreams. 18. And it shall come to pass in the... Sorry, 18. Okay, it is Act 2. And on my main servant, the same one. And my main servant, I will pour out my spirit in those days. These are the days. Because the word of God has come. And they shall prophesy. You will be prophesying to your life. You will not be calling your prophet or your pastor to prophesy. You will be prophesying. Because you are anointed. Why? The Spirit of God is upon you. Hallelujah. You'll be prophesying to situations. You'll be prophesying to your children. You'll be prophesying to your businesses. Oh my goodness. And these are the days. May it be so in Jesus' name. Now to each one. Those each one. Hallelujah. Another scripture. Oh, 1 Corinthians 12:7-11. And I love verse 11. We can read just verse 11. 1 Corinthians 12:7. Just light for Revelation 7.
11. Yeah, I'm almost finishing. It's only two remaining. We finish. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to each one for the profit of all. Each one. Who are these? Which one? Each one. Everybody. Manifestation, my friend. Ini mzuri sana. Two. Wacha tusome. Next. For to one is given the word of wisdom. This one is not a man. This one, it is whoever the Spirit wants to give, can be a man or a woman. Hallelujah. For to one is given the word of wisdom. These are the gifts we need. Gift of wisdom, gift of want of knowledge. Oh my goodness. And by the way, I don't see women in this. Why do they not flow in this? We ourselves, because we are hearing this one. This one is positioning us. God wants us to move with these gifts. For to one is given the word of wisdom through the Spirit, to another the word of knowledge through the same Spirit. Can't you become that one? Kasirika. Sasa kwa nini umetoseka na una kitu? Na hizi ni vitu bure. Hebu tuende bila maripa. Una kupanga line kwa supermarket. Hebu tuone. Oi mamungu. Hii tuombe wapendwa. Niko very serious. Msione kama ni jokes. Sasa ni nini? To another faith by same Spirit. Faith kama ile tunasoma ya Biblia. Mtu ana imani mpaka Yesu anasema imani yako imekuponya. And we give our pastors and the rest is a time to do ministry. Kwa sababu tu ni imani. Asemi, unajua tunaendanga kwa Yesu kama ni imani yake. Sio imani yake, ama kwa pasta. Nakuja ate kwa pasta. Pasta, kugua mugongo, ugonjwa inatoka mugu kichwa kupanda. Una imani. Hata pasta anastuka. To another faith by the same Spirit. To another gift of healing. Me, I'm telling you, I have a passion for this. Oh, people who are hearing me, pray for me. I love this gift. Gift of healing. Sijui nasikianga kama nikipata nitakuwa naenda baka Kenyatta. Nasikia hiyo ni ndisonda. Lakini tu, hii naipenda. Amen. Gift of, I really love it. Woman of God, I love this gift. I love. Every time you mention me, be reminding God. Because I think I prayed, I stopped. I love it so much. Gift of healings by the same Spirit. Mm-hmm. To another, the working of miracles, yama, na moriro, mugu wa ikuwa, inamea. Hiyo sipendi sana inanistuanga. Amen. But, you know, but it is good. Mutuwa na mugu, ewe na tulipanda na ye. Atoke na mugu, itanichukua munda ni muamini. Amen. Amen. It will distract me. But it is a good gift. Amen. Amen. We, pastor. Tukunje na wewe ukiwa hivu alafu mara moja. Kitamba turundanishe na wewe. Tupelekane na wewe. Nitaita woman of God tukusunguze. Unaona sasa hiyo ndio. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, discerning of spirit. Mtu akiingia hapa unajua huyu. 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 Anako. To another, different kind of tongues. This one. I have so many people who have this. Different kinds of tongues. Ongea lugha mingi. Even when you go into prayers. Have you ever prayed in a language? You are praying in tongues lakini unasikia naongea kimasai. I have a prayer, tulikuwa prayer center, aliongea, sasa mtu mumasai, ama murwanda, nakunja na kuambia ile yote umesema. Difference. When you are praying to Hindu, Mungu anakupatia lugha yako. Ndiyo uingie kabisa. It is good. To another, the interpretation of tongues. May God help us. verse 11. Let's finish. But one and the same spirit works all these things, distributing to each one.
Si ukasirike to each one individually as he wills, individually mumama, your daughter, anaweza patiwa wewe uchaguliwe, mume wako ama muke mume aachwe, wa mama hamkeni. Na mimi sijui kwa nini naona kama hizi vipawa zinangoja wa mama. Wa mama arise. Amen. Kitu meziona mingi zina wa baba, wa mama. Mungu anataka mutembee na hizi gifts. May God help us. And the Holy Spirit, verse 11, he gives them to women, to men, individual, without dividing them. Hallelujah. To each one, just as he determines. So the Holy Spirit considered women. In whatever he was doing, he had women. And even now, in whatever he wants to do here on this planet Earth, he has women in his mind. Imagine. No wonder he could be is telling anakaka to tell it kwa sababu women are not ready. This one is making you ready. It is preparing you. Acts 21:9, you write about the four daughters of Philip who are prophets. This one daughter. Another one, women were part. I just want us to wind with this. Women were part of Jesus' ministry. Let us lean the scripture in Luke 8. Verse 1 to 3. Women were part of Jesus' ministry. Hallelujah. Women. So wale wanasema, wana kina mama, awatakiwi. Afadhali usitakiwe na watu, utakiwe na Yesu. Let's lean. Now it came to pass afterwards that he went through every city and this is Jesus. Preaching and bringing the glad tidings of the kingdom of God. And the 12 were with him. Kando na hao 12 disciples. Angalieni verse 2. And certain. Hawana majina. Kwa sababu ya vile walikuwa wengi. Lakini kuna wengine. It doesn't matter. Even if I become that certain woman. Lakini naombanga ni mzuri njina yangu ya pia. Women who had been healed of evil spirit and wale walitendewa miujiza ndio walikuwa nafuata Mungu sana. Wengi hapa tumetendewa miujiza, unauliza ni gani hivyo? Hiyo sasa ya kuuliza ni gani? Una mdomo, unapumua. Hiyo ni muujiza mkubwa sana. Hakuna maiti yanaulizanga hivyo. Amen. Ete ni gani? Nimesikia. Ni gani sasa nimetendewa? Hiyo sasa ya kunjishika hivyo. Na mkono inajikunja. Hiyo ni muujiza. Omba unjue hiyo ingine next. Infirmity. Mary called Magdalene. I love this woman. Out of whom he had the 7 demons. Wewe hata unjuangi ndimoni zile umetolewa, unaendanga tu hivyo. Huyo alikuwa na njua 7. Labda wewe hata unanges. Huyo alikuwa na njua 7. Na ndio namumpenda sana. Demon 7 si mchezo, man of God. Nyinyi mnaniangalia, hebu tu hesabu moja ya wamama. Gossip. Hiyo ni moja tu. Kwani mumeshindwa 7? Mtu akikunja hapa uone demon 7 na umtoe. Ingine kwa mama. Woi, si tusaidiane. Pride, hiyo hata iko. Arrogant, hiyo iko na nini? Hiyo iko na mpaka wanaume za wamama specialist. Kahamba. Ukiona simeandikwa si ni zile nzito. Kwenda kwa waganga. Number 1, ivito. Sio tu ni 3. mumeshindwa hizo zingine ine. And then muka find out.
Major!
Si hizi ya TV yanga what? Hizi ni major, hui mumama. Ndiyo alimpenda Yesu hivyo.
And Joan!
Sio tu wale wametolewa nini, wanapendanga Yesu.
And Joan, the wife of Chusa, Herodian stewards, and Susanna, and many other who provided for him for their substances.
Women, if you are not going to arise, you are going to delay the move of God. Because God is waiting for women to start serving, to arise and start serving with their materials.
They were providing.
Provisions comes from people who are able to give something.
Hallelujah!
You are there, you have something you can provide. This time, it is like imebadilishanwa. Mumeomba sana, Mungu nipe, Mungu nipe, Mungu anakuita umpe.
They were providing him from their substances. Change your prayers.
God has been giving you. Father, we worship you. How I pray we be found somewhere. Even if you are a certain woman. Even if you are among the many. Even if your name is mentioned like Susanna. Like the wife of Susa. Herodian steward. Alikuwa tajiri. Hallelujah. Wamama matajiri. Wanaitwa wafanye kazi ya Mungu. We can serve God with what we have. And this is now what is helping me to see. Women are rich.
Hallelujah.
You cannot provide if you don't have.
Uh-huh.
And that's why they are called substances. Substances can be land.
Uh-huh.
Substances can be car.
Yes.
You give what you have.
Yes.
Substances can be a house.
Yes.
We need those women.
Hallelujah.
Those are the women we are putting into ministry. And I feel that is what is being waited.
Women to arise so that we can move and move faster.
Because in the work of the ministry, we need people who are going to provide for the work of the ministry. For the work of God. I just request us to stand and thank God because of helping us to know who we are. As far as concerned. Father, we worship you. And we need these people. Thank you, God, for delivering us. Tell God, thank you for delivering men and women today. Wherever you are, this is the word of deliverance. Hallelujah. The deliverance, the sure deliverance, comes from the truth. And today we have received the truth of God telling us who we are. Telling us that we are still in his mind. Oh my goodness. Father, I give you praise. Father, I give you praise. I worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, mighty one of Israel. Thank you, Jehovah. We are here for you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Redeemer, for removing foolishness. Oh my God, through your word. Thank you, Jehovah God, for enlightening us through your word. Thank you, mighty one of Israel. Oh my God, for equipping us through your word. Thank you, Jehovah God, for sharpening us through your word. Thank you, my God, for giving us wisdom through your words. Above all, thank you for helping us to know who we are in you so that we can continue, Jehovah. We are not what the enemy says. We are not what people say about us. Women, I'm declaring deliverance even in your life. My goodness. And I declare you are women of skills. I declare you are women of ideas. Receive the Holy Spirit from where you are. And you are going to emerge. You are going to showcase Christ. You are going to arise. As I started by saying, arising is to get up. I declare and get up in the mighty name of Jesus. To arise is to start existing. It doesn't matter what has been pressing you down by the authority and the anointing of God that he has bestowed unto.
to me. I decree and decree a woman arise, a woman to resume to exist, a human to reappear, a woman to service, a woman to emerge, a woman to occur, a woman to pop up. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, mighty one of Israel. We thank you. We bless you. Thank you for equipping us. Thank you for thinking good of us. Do as the Bible says in the word of Jeremiah. The thought you have for us, they are good thoughts to give us a future and a hope. I refuse any woman there to be hopeless, because Jeremiah 29 is our word. In the mighty name of Jesus.